Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Axel Threlfall, editor at large, Reuters.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm honored to be introducing our keynote speaker this afternoon. You've probably noticed the focus on sub-Saharan Africa at this year's Concordia event. As part of that, there are several strategic dialogues taking place tomorrow on driving sustainable economic development in the region. This keynote fits extremely well into that overall theme. Nana Akufo-Addo is the president of Ghana, an office he has held since January of last year. Before I ask him to take the podium, please allow me a few brief words to set the stage. Since the NPP came to power 19 months ago, much has been promised and much has been achieved. As a candidate on the campaign trail back in 2016, the president vowed to change the face of Ghana, in his words, to pull the country out of stagnation and backwardness and onto a path of progress and prosperity. Expectations are therefore very high, but the verdict seems to be that the president is delivering. Committed to building a country focused on the proper management of its own resources, he has vowed to tackle corruption. He has called for closer trade ties with countries across Africa. And after a year of disciplined economic management, most, if not all, of Ghana's macroeconomic indicators are showing positive signs. Meeting with China's president earlier this month, the president said his country is considering issuing a 100-year, $50 billion bond as part of a long-term industrialization plan that aims to wean Ghana off aid. We do not want to remain the beggars of the world, he said in a speech last year in London. We do not want to be dependent on charity. Now, the markets might be a little skeptical that Ghana can pull off such an ambitious fundraising, and critics cry over optimism, but this is the president's vision for a new Ghana, a Ghana beyond aid, something he has said that requires a deliberate, qualitative change in the structure of the economy, the nature of Ghana's infrastructure, and the education of its youth. One final thing, if you can remain in your seats after the president has finished speaking, he will be receiving an Outstanding Leaders Award on behalf of the U.S. Africa Business Center at the U.S. Chamber of Commerce for his work in promoting trade and investment in Ghana. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome His Excellency, President Akufo-Addo.
Ladies and gentlemen, I must at the outset say how delighted and honored I am to be here this afternoon, to be in the midst of such an excellent gathering of people. On behalf of the people and government of Ghana, I thank the U.S. Chamber of Commerce and its U.S. Africa Business Center warmly for the honor of this award, the 2018 Outstanding Leaders Award. It's good to know that advocating for Ghana to opt for partnership with the rest of the world on the basis of trade and investment cooperation, not aid, has its rewards. The Ghanaian people are humbled by the award, and we accept the challenge that it imposes on us and in what the world expects of Ghana. The receipt of this award and the recitation to be read to this effect represents a summary of my focus as Ghana's president since assuming the reins of office some 21 months ago. I have sought not only to strengthen my country's democratic credentials, but also to help create wealth and provide opportunities for its people. Ladies and gentlemen, Ghana, like most countries in Africa, is blessed with an abundance of human and natural resources. However, we have been over the years been heavily reliant on the production and export of these natural resources in their raw form. We've also not taken deliberate steps to create an educated workforce to spur on the development of our country. Unsurprisingly, we've not been able to bring sufficient progress and prosperity to the mass of Ghanaians. This sad state of affairs has deepened our reliance on aid, charity, and handouts, thereby making us vulnerable to the politics of foreign powers. We've decided to try to buck this trend, as it is the only way we can bring wealth to the Ghanaian people and hold the dynamic of our young men and women leaving the country in search of allegedly greener pastures abroad. We want thus to emulate the path of prosperity taken by countries that have become today's success stories, especially those of Asia. That is why my government has fashioned a program of economic transformation hinged on restructuring the institutions of our governance, modernizing our agriculture to enhance its productivity, implementing a clear industrial policy, and rationalizing the financial sector so that it supports growth in agriculture and growth in manufacturing and industry. We are creating a resilient and robust economy, and the macroeconomic indices at the halfway point of my term of office are pointing in the right direction, a direction that will be maintained so that we can provide the stability to stimulate investments. At the beginning of my government's mandate, we confronted an economy that was in steep decline, having obtained a growth rate of 3.6% in 2016, the lowest in 22 years. By dint of hard work and prudent management, GDP growth rate grew to 8.5% in our first year. This year, we're expected to grow at 8.3%, which, according to the International Monetary Fund, will make us one of the world's fastest growing economies. Sector after sector, we're making significant advances. We've also taken steps to formalize the Ghanaian economy, and in the process, we aim to establish the most business-friendly economy in Africa to enable the private sector to thrive. Our modest successes in making progress in these areas are being recognized by the global business community that is now eager to engage with Ghana. Recently, our overarching goal to diversify our economy from being a producer and exporter of raw materials to dealing with the world on the basis of things we make, received a major boost when two global car giants, Volkswagen of Germany and Sinotruk of Ghana, announced that they will be establishing very soon assembly plants in Ghana with the intention in the medium term of producing these vehicles, their vehicles, in the country. Tech giant Google has also decided to base its African Artificial Intelligence Center in Ghana, which will make it the first in Africa. ExxonMobil has also signed an agreement with the Ghana National Petroleum Corporation, GNPC, to undertake deep water oil exploration and production. For us, the rapid enhancement of foreign direct investment is an essential ingredient in realizing our vision of a Ghana beyond aid, that is, building in Ghana a strong, productive economy capable of generating a dignified, prosperous existence for its people and banishing the specter of poverty. Ghana is forging ahead. We want to be a force to reckon with on the continent and in the world. We will develop, we will industrialize, we'll educate our people, and we will add value to our abundant natural resources. So, I urge representatives of Fortune 500 companies present here to look at Ghana and not to ignore her. You can choose to invest through the Ghana Investment Promotion Center or to set up as a company in our free zones enclave. Regardless of where the investment is, government has instituted a number of incentives for the investor, depending on the nature of the activity or the location of the investment. This is to ensure that your investment succeeds. I assure you that your investments will be safe, in fact, and will be protected by law. I'm confident that through our policies, we can bring greater dignity to the lives of millions of people in Ghana and beyond. It will not be easy. We have no illusions whatsoever about the nature of the task that we face, but I know we can rise to the occasion, as we did when we led the continent in the struggle for the liberation of Africa from colonialism and imperialism. The black star is going to shine and shine and shine, and we're going to construct a Ghana beyond aid. I thank the U.S. Chamber of Commerce and its U.S.-Africa Business Center once again for this award. I'll do my best not to let the side down. May God bless us all and the peoples of Ghana and the United States of America, and may God bless our homeland, Ghana, and make her great and strong. I thank you for your attention.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Myron Brilliant and Scott Eisner from the U.S. Chamber of Commerce.
So first of all, on behalf of the U.S. Chamber's Africa Business Center and the U.S. Chamber's American Chamber affiliate in Ghana, thank you all for being here to be a witness of this award. I want to say at the outset, what you heard from the President is true. His efforts to reduce poverty, to address economic plight, to increase economic opportunity, his work to grow the economy, which is now running about 8.5% since he took office when it was running low threes. The work that he's done to fight corruption, to improve the rule of law, is really a tribute to President Akufo-Addo, and we wanted to recognize him with this prestigious award from the U.S. Chamber of Commerce. It is an award that we don't give lightly, we take seriously, and we do it out of respect to what the President has done in Ghana. So please give him a round of applause.
Ghana, Ghana, stop, stop,